भोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। श्रीमत सदगुरु सरकार की जय। राधा रानी की जय। Let's all focus our minds on the lotus feet of Guru and Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Agyanatimirandhasya Jnana Janashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Parthaya Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayane Naswayam Vyase Nagratitam Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitamrita Varshini Bhagavati Mashtadhyayini Mambatva Manusandhadhami Bhagavad Gite Bhavadveshini Namostu Te Vyasa Vishala Buddhe Fular Vindayat Patnetra Yenatvaya Bharata Taila Purna Prajwalito Gyanamaya Pradipa Prapanna Parijataya तोत वेत्रैक पानये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृत दुहे नमः सर्वोपनिषदो गावो दुग्धा गोपाल नंदना पार्थो वत्स सुधीर भोक्ता दुग्धम गीतामृतम महत् वसुदेव सुतम देवम कंसचानूरमर्दनम् देवकी परमानंदम् कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुम् भीष्मद्रोणतटाजयध्रतजला गांधारनीलोत्पला शल्यग्राहवती कृपेण वहनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला अश्वत्थाम विकर्ण घोर मकरा दुर्योधना वर्तिनी सोक्तीर्णा खलु पांडवैन रननदी कैवर्त कह केशव पाराशर्य वचः सरोज ममलम गीतार्थ गंधोत्कटम नानाख्यानक केसरम हरिकथा संबोधना बोधितम् लोके सज्जन षट्पदैरहर पेपीयमानं मुदा भूयाद् भारत पंकजं कलिमल प्रध्वंसिनः श्रेयसे मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुलं घयते गिरिम् यत् कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंद माधवम् यम् ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतस्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः सांकपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यम् सामगाः ध्यानावस्थित तद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यम योगिनो यस्यांतं न विरुसुरा सुरगणा देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः। भोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। प्रिय सज्जनों भक्त समुदाय, विप्र मंडली, महानुभाव, डिवोटीज ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, डियरेस्ट डिवोटीज, डिवाइन सोल्स, फर्स्ट लेट मी से राधे राधे टू ईच एंड एवरीवन एंड माय प्रणाम एंड हम्बलेस्ट प्रोस्ट्रेशंस टू ऑल ऑफ यू. Tonight we embark on a journey, continued journey. Previously I had done 8 nights of Gita lectures when we were celebrating Gita Jayanti from New York City, Shamasham Dham. And we're going to continue the journey tonight for 9 nights from where we left off. From Gita Jayanti. The last verse I did in Gita Jayanti was chapter 5, verse 18. So I'll be starting from chapter 5, verse 19, going on. And those who want to follow can follow if you have your Gita, etc. We see how far we can go in 9 nights. Though not going to promise we're going to finish. Of course not. We can go as far as we can and then we'll go again some other time. If by God's grace, Bhagwan showers His grace, Guru showers His grace upon us, then we have the blessing and I can try to be of seva, of service to you some more. Before we go into Gita, let us focus our mind, try to get our mind inclined and absorbed in the Bhagwan, and we leave the world, the worries of the world and tensions of the world and what's happening, and try to focus our mind on the lotus feet of Bhagwan Shri Krishna, on the lotus feet of the spiritual master. Bhajo Giridhar Govinda Gopala.
Oh,
कुल वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। गीता इहैव तैर्जितः सर्गो येषां साम्ये स्थितं मनः निर्दोषं हि समं ब्रह्म तस्माद् ब्रह्मणि ते स्थिताः। Chapter 5, verse 19, Gita. जिसके मन सामान्य रूप रहते हैं और जन्म मरण का डर जो होते हैं वो जीत किया तो वो ब्रह्म समान हो जाते हैं, ब्रह्म में स्थिर हो गए। दिस गीता वर्स सेज दोज हुज माइंड्स आर एस्टैब्लिश इन द सेमनेस equanimity, meaning they don't see high and low, they see everywhere same. Siyaram mai sab jag jani karhu pranam jori jug pani. Everywhere, seeing God, in every particle of the world, or seeing the soul. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hridaye shedun tishtati. Isha vasmi dagvam sarvam, purukha eve dagvam sarvam. Everywhere, seeing equality, sameness. They have already conquered birth and death. When you reach a stage that you see everywhere Bhagwan, you see equality, you see sameness in everything, then you have already conquered birth and death. In other words, you're not going to come back in this avagaman, in the endless cycle of birth and death. We, the jivatma, the individual soul, have been rotating in 8.4 million forms of life. आकर चारि लाख चौरासी योनि भ्रमत यह जीव अविनाशी। भगवान श्री राम से सुरवेजन अयोध्या राम गीता रामायण The jivatma, the individual soul, who we are, we're not a body. This body belongs to us. This is a material thing. Kshiti jala pavaka gagana samira kshiti. Earth, jal, water. Pavak, fire. Gagan, space. Samira, wind. Five elements. Panchara chitta yaha adhama sarira. This body is made of five elements. It's material. We're not that. When the life leaves this body, that's the end. Earth goes back to earth, water to water, fire to fire, air to air, space to space. Soul? Nainam chindanti sastrani, nainam dahati pavakaha, na chainam klidayantyapu, na shoshayati marutaha. Chapter 2, verse 23, Gita. It cannot be cut by any weapon. Shastra. It can't be burned by fire, pavak. Apo, apaha, water, cannot wet it. It can't be dried by the wind. Marut. The same forever. But of course, until we attain, until we reach that stage, we have to come back again and again, rotating. तो आकर चारी लाख चौरासी लाख लाख चौरासी चौरासी लाख चौरासी मीन्स 84 लाख 8.4 million forms of life we keep rotating. Uncountable times we've done already. There's no form of life that the soul hasn't gone in. This soul, the same soul that is in this human body, the same soul is in the dog, in the cat, in the worm, in the tree, in the grass, in the bird, in the rakshas, in the devata. Celestial being. Keep rotating. Yoni brahmata yah jeev. This soul keeps wo brahman karte hai. In all these forms of life, it rotates. So one who has attained this, we're talking about God realization, more or less, Sri Krishna is saying to Arjuna. He has conquered birth and death, meaning that he doesn't come back in this avagaman. When you reach a stage where you see the same everywhere, you don't see difference. Then you have crossed. Once you've crossed Maya, someone can come back as a saint, bhakt, not jnani, bhakt saint. A saint who is a devotee. Jnani saint doesn't come back. Once you merge into the formless absolute Brahm, no one comes back. So bhakt saint comes back as a saint. We have realized God. So Bhagwan says, okay, the souls are suffering. Go back as guru. So that soul's come back, that soul who has attained God realization comes back as guru. But he's beyond birth and death. He's beyond the body. He just comes to help all the sinners, sinful souls, to teach them to go to Bhagwan. Because we don't listen. Instead we try to kill them, give them a bad name, etc. So that soul becomes just as Brahm, meaning same as God, flawless. He's beyond all defects. Maya se pare ho gaye. He's gone beyond Maya. All the defects that we have in us, greed, anger, jealousy, hatred, lust, this is a consequence of being governed by Maya. These are all products of Maya. These are children. One who's gone beyond, who's crossed Maya, no longer has any of the defects of Maya. So they're, because they're always situated in Brahm now, in Bhagavan. This is, we continue. Na parishet priyam prapya. No dvijet prapya cha priyam sthira buddhir asam mudho brahma vid brahmani sthitah. Chapter 5, verse 20, Gita. Na parishet priyam prapya. कुछ अच्छे बढ़िया बढ़िया चीज मिलते हैं तो खुश नहीं होते हैं कि अच्छा घर मिल गया, एक मर्सिडीज बेंज गाड़ी मिल गया तो बहुत खुश है. ऐसा नहीं है. और अच्छे चीज ना मिले तो दुखी भी नहीं होता. सच ए सोल. So having crossed that stage, attaining that stage, the previous verse, in other words, God realization, what happens after that? This is the condition of such a being, entity. We call a saint, Mahapurush, Guru. The real Guru, not what we call Guru mostly in the world. Just making chela, followers, how many chelas I can have. So, Such a person having attained that position doesn't rejoice. He can get the best thing in the world. Sabse priya vastu. What we consider to be the best thing, somebody, a Mercedes Benz car, best thing to eat, the best clothes, $1 million dress, sari, diamond jewelry, has no effect. Doesn't bring, cause rejoicing in him. Out, no vijayat prapya, and cha priyam. If he doesn't get anything good, what we consider good in the world, it doesn't cause him to lament also and be sorrowful. If we get something, oh, we think that this will make me happy. If I can get this kind of motor car, if I can have this kind of house, bungalow, palace, want to have a house like this, a house like that. How many bedrooms, how many, and then we have to have swimming pool and this. We make plan because we think this will make us happy. And we don't get it, we get sad. Or we don't have the money, we think, oh, I wish I could have something like that. I wish I can have a motor car, a thing like that. We get very sad when we think about it, that I'm not able to have this kind of dress to wear, this kind of pant, this kind of jewelry. I wish I was like this guy who's wearing, oh, he has all this kind of cars to drive, etc. No, this doesn't cause any difference in it. But I have or doesn't have, same thing. Stirab buddhir asam moodho. So the intellect has become very steady. It's become very steady and has become free from all delusion. What's the delusion? Ye gyan kya hai? Ye mukt ho gaye bhram se. What it means is become free from delusion. The delusion that I will find something in the world is going to make me happy. Some person or object. Wo to mil gaya. He's attained the supreme bliss, supreme happiness. So no longer that delusion is there. Number one delusion, my kaun. The number one delusion, who am I? Is gone because now he's realized I'm the soul, Atma. Whether you're doing bhakti, gyan, once you reach a stage, you've realized I'm the soul, the Atma. So that delusion is gone, number one. Second delusion, obviously now, having attained that happiness of Sri Krishna, that supreme divine happiness, nothing in the world can compare. You multiply how many times you want, billions and billions and trillions of times, any happiness in the world still cannot equal even the tiniest drop. Soi sukha lavalesh barik jina sapane hulahi tenahi ganahi khagesh brahma sukai sajjana sumati. Tusadas, the great saint Tusadas Ji Maharaj says that if we were to taste the tiniest drop, lavalesh, the tiniest drop of true happiness, even once, even in dream, sapna, then we are sure to forget the bliss of the formless absolute Brahma, that which the jnanis experience. Then what to speak of the mundane pleasures of the world? Imagine, the tiniest drop of that, you will forget what jnanis are aiming for, Brahmanan, the bliss of the formless absolute Brahman. Then how can this worldly things attract such a person? So he's become free from all that delusion because he's become a knower. Brahmavid means he has attained Brahman, he has known and become a knower of Brahman. Brahmavid. A Brahmanisthitaha. He is now situated in God. This is a saint. He's describing here what a saint is. What is God realization? Many times this question is asked, how would I know? I have attained. Yeah, this you will know. This will be your condition. Before that, already someone is practicing bhakti, just practicing. Especially, someone is under the guidance of a true saint, a true God-realized soul, rasik saint, and has started to practice bhakti, truly bhakti, shedding tears for God. The taste, the bliss, the true Guru's grace, according to how much the heart purifies, Guru gives, experiences. The rasik saint, the true Guru. Worldly Guru has nothing, can't give you anything. His kripa hai nahi, doesn't have what can he give? You have to have something to give it. So Guru gives according to the vessel. Patra ke anusar, wo zyada nahi de sakte. According to how much we have purified, we have followed Guru's instruction, agya palan, agya palan. Sabse pramukh, most important, following the instruction of Guru. Many of us, we're doing bhakti, I am satsangi, I am this, I am that, and do we follow Guru's instruction? No. We do whatever our mind says. Sleep as much as we want. Eat whatever we want. Think negative thoughts about people. Have negative thoughts. Do kusang. Complain about this, about that. Can't keep it quiet. I got to tell somebody. This thing is bothering me. So we go against all Guru's instruction. Then how are we going to benefit? You're making the heart, the mind even more and more dirty by doing that. Take a dirty piece of cloth and dip it in a dirty bucket of water, it gets more dirty. Or ganda. Even if we shed 2 tears, then we go back and we do wrong things. We don't follow. We got to be very careful with this mind. By nature, the mind is very dirty. It loves the world. It loves dirty things. The more dirty the mind is, the more dirty things it loves. Gossiping. Hearing negative things about people, saying negative things. If there is some purity, you can't bear to hear about, you can't bear to be in such people's company. You don't want to hear those things. It causes irritation. Just as somebody who doesn't believe in God, an atheist, if you talk to him about God, he'll get irritated, angry. In the same way, someone who is a true devotee, whose purity has come because he's following Guru's instruction, agya palan kiya. Some purity has come. Cannot. Little bit of worldly talks and gets irritated. Anything worldly. So check ourselves. Check. Don't call yourself satsangi and what, and then nothing is happening. You're doing, going totally against Guru's instruction. We have to be very careful of the mind. See what the mind is doing. Always have the feeling, Bhagawan and Guru, the saint is looking at me. The one whose love I want is looking at me every moment. Practice that, practice that. Make it a fact. It's the nature of the mind to think wrong, do wrong. But when we have this thing that Maharaji is looking, Radha Krishna is looking, ooh, you will stop the thought. And practice. We'll do a bhajan. Since we are talking about Guru, the topic of Guru, some of the things that Guru does, this beautiful bhajan written by Kripalu Mahaprabhu, page 98. Bhajan says, the merciful master, the spiritual master, the true Guru, the true saint, is my only shelter. I bow to his lotus feet. I surrender to his lotus feet. I bow to the lotus feet of the Guru, that lotus feet which is the makes everything auspicious. Mangalam api. Mangala Karanam. It makes everything auspicious. Mangal, Mangal. So important is Guru Charan, lotus feet of the Guru, of the saint. What does Guru do? Maya Moha Jal Haranam. Guru frees us from the tie, the bindings, the moho. Moho means the binding attachments of Maya. Guru, when we meet a true Guru, when you have association with a true Guru, he breaks all of that if you follow his instruction, take shelter in the true way. All these ties get broken. Yoga Kshem Bhan Karna. Shri Krishna says in Gita, those who worship me exclusively and surrender themselves wholeheartedly unto me, to them I bring attainment of what they do not have. I bring attainment of what they do not have and protect what they have. Yoga Kshemam Bahamyaham, chapter 9, verse 22. But this is saint. Ananya Shintayantu Mam, one who is completely surrendered and exclusively, the mind doesn't stray from Sri Krishna even for a moment. That's God realization. Before that, Guru does, when you take shelter in a true saint, a true Guru, he does Yoga Kshemam Bahamyaham. He brings attainments of what you do not have and protect what you have. Asharana Sharana Guru Charanam. I take shelter in the lotus feet of the Guru, Guru who gives shelter to those who have no shelter. What do you mean I have no shelter? I have a house? No, not that, not that. Not that kind of shelter. When you do not have any faith, depend on anyone and anything in the world, I have no one and nothing in the world, then Guru becomes everything for you. Gopi Prem Bhav Bharanam. When the heart is ready, Guru of course makes the vessel. He's the one who's going to purify it, make it, if you follow and do what he says, then he fills in that divine, in that pure heart, Gopi Prem, the love of the gopis for Sri Krishna, the highest love. Radha Krishna Prema Bharanam. Again, he fills the heart with the love of Sri Radha and Krishna.
Guru Kripalur Mam Sharanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Guru Kripalur Mam Sharanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Mangalam Api Mangal Karanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Mangalamati Mangal Karanam Vandeham Sai Guru Charanam.
Maya Moha Jal Haranam Vandeham Sai Guru Charanam. Guru Kripalu, Guru Kripalu, Mam Sharanam, Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Guru Kripalu, Mam Sharanam, Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Yoga Kshema Bahan Karanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Yoga Kshema Vahan Karanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Asharana Sharanam Guru Charanam Vandeham Sat Guru Charanam.
Asharana Sharanam Guru Charanam Vandeham Sai Guru Charanam.
O Guru Kripalu, Guru Kripalu Mam Sharanam Vandeham Sai. सत गुरु चरणम
गुरु कृपा कृष्ण प्रेम करुणम वंदे हम सत गुरु चरणम
राधा कृष्ण प्रेम भरणम वंदे हम सत गुरु चरणम गुरु कृपालु गुरु कृपालु मम शरणम वंदे हम सत गुरु चरणम
गुरु कृपालु मम शरणम वंदे हम सत गुरु चरणम।
बोले श्रीमत् सद्गुरु सरकार की
जय।
नेक्स्ट वर्स।
बाह्य स्पर्शे व्य सत्तात्मा विन्दत्यात्मनि यत् सुखम् सब्रह्म योग युक्तात्मा सुखमोक्षयमश्नुते।
FiveTwenty-One गीता। जो बाहर का जो विषय है उसमें आसक्ति नहीं होते हैं, ऐसे इस तरह की व्यक्ति के लिए जो बाहरी विषय है, क्योंकि जो आनंद मिलते हैं अंदर तो बाहर वाले नहीं आ सकते। Such a person is not attracted to this outer senses, the material pleasures in the world, sensual pleasures. No matter how strong, it's very difficult. Sensual urges, sensual pleasures. The mind gets pulled again and again. One who is in this position, because of the intense pleasure he's enjoying, being at one with Bhagavan on the inside, that supreme bliss, supreme happiness, the outer material sensual pleasures cannot pull him away. We cannot challenge before God realization. Sometimes we practice a little bit and we think I have attained everything. And then we get in big trouble. Maya is very powerful. This Maya, just by saying, a lot of people say Maya is an illusion. Ye mithya hai. Thinking Maya cannot cause any harm to them. It's very foolish to think like that.
Daivi hesha gunamai mama maya duratyaya. मामे वये प्रपद्यन्ते माया मेतां तरन्तिते।
Chapter 7 verse 14 Gita, Sri Krishna says Maya is a divine power, Daivi Hesha, and more important, Meri Maya. He says Maya is a power that belongs to him, it is his power. To defeat Maya, we have to defeat Krishna, defeat Bhagavan.
सो दासी रघुबीर की समुझै मिथ्या सोपी छुटै न राम कृपा बिनु नाथ कहूं पद रूपी।
माया तुलसीदास जी सेन इज द दासी द मेड सर्वेंट ऑफ भगवान इन अदर वर्ड्स हिज पावर।
मायां तु प्रकृति विद्यान माइनम तु महेश्वरम तस्या वैव भूतैस्तु व्याप्तम सर्वमिदं जगत।
श्वेताश्रुतरोपनिषद चैप्टर 4 वर्स 10।
माइनम तु महेश्वरम The Vedas are saying Maya is a power that belongs to Bhagavan. It is his power. He's the governor of Maya. Sit down. So Maya is a power that belongs to Bhagavan. That's why to defeat Maya, we have to defeat Bhagavan. And how to defeat Bhagavan? Bhagavan says, Mame vaye prapadyante. Only the one who completely surrenders to him. Purna shanagati. Bhakti. When you be completely surrendered to Bhagwan, to Shri Krishna, then Shri Krishna will say to Maya, okay, leave this one now. He's mine. No yogi, no rishi, no jnani, no muni, no devata, no one can cross Maya by themselves through their own efforts. Apne bal se. Maya ko paar kar sakte. Why? Because this is Bhagwan's own personal power. Maya is eternal, beginningless. Just like Bhagwan. Ajam ekam lohita shukla krishnam bahavi prajaha srijamanam sarupa ajohe kujushamanu nushete jahatenam bhukta bhogam ajonya. Shweta Sutra Upanishad, chapter 4, verse 5. Aja means unborn, eternal, beginningless. Never had a beginning, will never have an end. No one can destroy Maya, not even Bhagavan can destroy Maya. Bhagavan can free us from Maya. We can become free from Maya. When Bhagavan frees us, but Maya will always be in existence. Maya will no longer have effect on the one who has become free from it. Once you become free from Maya, that's it. Sada pashyanti surya tat Vishnu paramam padam. The Vedas say it's for that Maya can never have effect on such a soul ever again. It's forever. So nothing in the world, the highest sensual pleasures, has no effect. Ye anant sukh. Anant sukh. Aseem sukh ko milte hai. Kyunki uske man hamesha Bhagwan mein leen hai. Such a soul attains infinite bliss, infinite happiness, because his mind is always absorbed in bhakti, in love with Shri Krishna. It's called Brahma Yoga. Yoga means join. His mind is joined to Brahma, to Shri Krishna. In bhakti, in love. Brahma Yoga means bhakti. It's joined in Shri Krishna with that love. Next verse.
Yehi sans Parshaja bhoga dukhyo naya evate adyantavanta kaunteya nate shuramate buddha.
522 Gita. Ab hum log jo maya ke andar mein hai, जिस पर माया हावी है, जो संसारी लोग हैं, हम लोग, तो हम लोग ढूंढते हैं सुख के लिए संसार में, संसारी सुखों में. और ये संसारी सुखों है, ये मूल है सब दुख दुखी दुख का सब दुख का मूल है संसार सुख संसारी सुख.
We people, we're looking for happiness in material because of ignorance.
Again,
we're searching and looking for happiness in material world, in material things. Material pleasures. So the mind is always in contact with material, the material pleasures, material things. And that is the source of all pain and suffering. Hearing this in the world doesn't sound correct. Because we have convinced, the mind has become convinced, from beginningless time, our mind has become convinced, I will find happiness in the world. So we keep looking again and again.
ध्यायतो विषयान पुंसा संगस्ते शुपजायते संगासंजायते कामा कामात क्रोधो भी जायते.
Chapter 2, verse 62 Gita. Again and again, I will find happiness, and we get attached. We get attached to that person or object. This thinking again and again, this boy will make me happy, this girl will make me happy, this motor car will make me happy, this house, this kind of food, this kind of clothes.
Bhagavat says the same thing. Shri Krishna says to Uddhava, Vishayadhyatashchittam vishayeshu visajyate mamanusmaratashchittam mayeva praviliyate.
11th canto, 14th chapter, 27th verse. Thinking again and again, bar-bar, again and again, that we'll find happiness in any person or object in the world, we get attached. And this attachment is the source of all sorrows and all suffering. Why is it the source? First, if we were to get the thing that we want in the world, we get it, we make it happiness temporarily, but it's followed by double fear and worry. And if we become separate from it, we lose it, even more pain and suffering. Before a woman has a child, she keeps thinking about when she will have a child, how happy she will be. She gets pregnant. Now, is she happy? Little bit. She's thinking, I will be able to when I see the child, but also she's not happy. All the free time she used to have, all the picnics, all the shopping, all this thing has to cut down now. She cannot go and see, go to the places she used to be able to go to freely. She's now tied down, bounded. She can go, but not as much as before. She has to be very careful. Then morning sickness, evening sickness, all kind of sickness. But the thought is there, oh, baby is there. She can feel the kicking, etc., in the stomach, in the womb. So she's happy in that thought. On the process of giving birth to the child, how much pain and suffering she goes through. Oh, this could only be understood by another mother who has given birth. I'm not talking you give an injection and then they fall asleep and you take it out. That happens also. Naturally birth. How much pain and suffering. The child is born, she's able to see the child, she forgets everything. She's so happy seeing the child, very happy. But now it's followed by double worry and fear that the child will get sick. I hope the child doesn't get sick. Something happened and he will die. Every moment is fear. She gets a small happiness, but now every moment she is scared. Constantly she is always worried. Worry and fear. And if she happens to lose the child dies, then even more pain and suffering. This is just one example. So, the contact with material, sensual pleasures in the world is the source of all pain and suffering. The decision, once as long as the decision is there, that we will find happiness in any pain or object, an object in the world. And this happiness that we get in the world is temporary. Kshanik hai, kshanik. Iska aadi bhi hai aur ant bhi hai. Shri Krishna is saying to Arjun, these happiness are transient. Small, momentarily. It has a beginning, it has an end. In other words, it's not true happiness. The definition for happiness, sukh. Yo vai bhuma tat sukham, bhumaiva sukham, chandogya upanishad. The Vedas give a definition for happiness. That which is infinite, unmeasurable, eternal, beginningless, is called sukh or happiness. Once attained, it is possessed forever. You will never become separate from it ever again. You will never experience sorrow ever again. Have we attained such a thing? Something makes us happy now, next moment we become sad. You're wishing that you had a certain type of car, that you could have enough money to buy this car. Somehow or the other you got enough money. A lot of pain and suffering, starvation, all kind of... Sometimes you try some crookedness, all kind of tricks and tactics, deceitfulness until you get the amount of money. This car becomes so much a thing in your mind to get that you will do anything. You eventually get the car. You're so happy. You go around showing this, you drive by the neighbors, by your friends and family, nobody invites you. I have a new car. You're so happy. And tomorrow, next week, next month, where did the happiness go? That was your delusion. All happiness in the world like that. All happiness is in the world like that. As an example, there's a very poor office boy. Bahut gareeb hai, very poor. He's planning, thinking about the day that he'll be able to buy a brand new bicycle. The office manager also dreaming about the day he'll be owner of a certain type of motor car, Lexus. Right now he has some Corolla or something. So he's dreaming about the day he'll be owner of a brand new Lexus. They keep saving money, etc. Starving themselves, doing all kind of things to save. If you have children, not giving the children what they want. I want ice cream, shut up, chup. I'm saving money here for something important. Eventually they have enough money. The office boy he buys a brand new bicycle. The office manager, a new Lexus. Brand new. They're very, very happy. Very happy. One day, by chance, the office boy he's in the office with the office manager. In the office managers, and the office manager comes into the office and calls him, and he's talking to another manager in the office and complains. He's complained to the other manager about having to have this car and drive it by himself. It's so hard driving this car and all this traffic and day and night. I have to drive. Oh, I hate this car. The office boy hearing this cannot believe his ear.
He can't imagine someone having a Lexus, any motor car can be unhappy. He thinks riding a bicycle is hard. He's no longer happy with his bicycle also too. But certainly not driving a motor car. That cannot be. How can he be sad driving a motor car? Anyhow, the office boy leaves his job. He goes and learns how to drive. Somehow or the other, he is able to learn how to drive, gets his license, and becomes a chauffeur for a very high minister. Cabinet minister, somebody very high position. He becomes a chauffeur, driver. For the first few days, he's very happy. But very soon, he curses his fate. As he has to pick up that minister's friend, sometimes somebody's coming, he has to go day and he has to be ready anytime. 12 o'clock midnight, the phone ring, has to have the phone on. Hey, so-and-so is in the airport, go and pick them up and bring them. Anytime he has to be ready. He has to take the minister's wife to shopping, the children to school, etc., etc. He's no longer happy. He is wishing that he was back riding his bicycle. So before we get something, we keep thinking, I'll be happy. When we get it, we find the happiness is only temporary and soon vanishes away. And sometimes can be overcome by pain and suffering. So this is the source of all misery. This thinking that I can find happiness in any person or object in the world. Attachment. That brings attachment, and from attachment, the source of all pain and misery. So, the wise person, jo gyani hai, the one who has true knowledge, that there is no happiness in any person or object in the world. Ki sansar mein na sukh hai na dukh hai. Jo sukh hum chahte hai, wo sukh Shri Krishna mein hi hai. Unko milte hi milega. The one who has a knowledge, wise means he has a knowledge that there is no happiness in any person or object in the world. The true happiness I'll find only in Shri Krishna, because Shri Krishna is happiness. He doesn't seek pleasure in any person or object in the material world. This is what is mean by wise, not how much degree you have and how much PhD and all that. That's not wise in the true sense. We'll do another bhajan. Page 113. This beautiful bhajan says, O mind, day and night, this is written by Kripalu Mahaprabhu again, Jagadguru Tam Shri Kripalu Mahaprabhu. Day and night sing the glories of Shri Krishna, the one who delights the heart of Radharani. Chinna chinna neha baraye ja. Every moment keep increasing your devotional feeling, your loving feeling. Pala pala prema baraye ja. And every moment constantly keep increasing your attachment for Radha, because that's where we're going to find true happiness. वो जीवन क्या जीवन जिसमें जीवन धन से प्यार न हो. What kind of life is that? What kind of life? वो जीवन, that life that there is no love for God, there is no true life. And the worldly person will say, people who love God, the worldly person will say, you have no life. And the person who loves God will say to the worldly person, you have no life. The true happiness, the real jivan, is when we have love for Radha Krishna. Hai woh pyar pyar kya jisme piya sukh mein balihar na ho. So the real pyar, the real love,
is when one sacrifices one's own happiness for the happiness of the beloved. To be happy in the happiness of the beloved. Tat sukha sukitvam. That's what is called true love. Shama sham milan hit nit prati nainan neer bahaye ja. How to meet Radha Krishna, how to get closer to God? We have to keep shedding tears for them, selflessly for them, every moment. Man govind guna gaye ja, jeevan safala banaye ja. Keep chanting the glories of Shri Radha, of Shri Krishna, every moment, and make this life a success. Priya pranan pyari sukumari. Radha Rani, she is very, very gentle. She is the life of Shri Krishna. And she is the daughter of King Vrishabhanu. Focus your mind on Radha Rani. Chakar bani nit chakar karat chakari sundar shama sujan. Even Shri Krishna has become a chakar. He has become a servant to Radha Rani. He wants to serve Radha Rani all the time. Prema kripalu sudha chakar hit radhe radhe gaye ja. Kripalu Mahaprabhu says, one, the only one who can taste the divine bliss, of divine love of Shri Krishna is the one who chants Radhe Radhe all the time. So keep chanting Radhe Radhe, make your life successful.
ओरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
ओरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
ओरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
ओरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
छिन छिन नेह बढ़ाए जा.
छिन छिन प्रेम
पल पल प्रेम बढ़ाए जा.
पल पल प्रेम बढ़ाए जा.
वह जीवन क्या जीवन जिसमें जीवन धन से प्यार न हो.
वह जीवन क्या
जीवन जिसमें
जीवन धन से प्यार न हो.
है वह प्यार प्यार क्या जिसमें है.
वह प्यार प्यार क्या जिसमें
प्रिय सुख में बलिहार न हो.
प्रिय सुख में बलिहार न हो.
ओ सुख में बलिहार न हो.
प्रिय सुख में बलिहार न हो.
ओ ओ रे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
ओ रे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश दिन गुण गन गाए जा.
श्यामा श्याम मिलन हित नित प्रति.
श्यामा श्याम मिलन हित नित प्रति
नैनन नीर बहाए जा.
नैनन नीर बहाए जा.
ओ नैनन नीर बहाए जा.
नैनन नीर बहाए जा.
मन गो पुन गाए जा
मन गोविंद गाए जा
जीवन सफल बनाए जा
जीवन सफल बनाए जा
ओ ओ रे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निशि दिन गुण गन गाए जा
मोरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निशि दिन गुण गन गाए जा
प्रिय प्राणन प्यारी सुकुमारी भानु दुलारी जान रे
प्रिय प्राणन प्यारी सुकुमारी भानु दुलारी जान रे
चाकर बनी नित करत चाकरी
चाकर बनी नित करत चाकरी
हो चाकर बनी नित करत चाकरी
चाकर बनी नित करत चाकरी
सुंदर श्याम सुजान रे
सुंदर श्याम सुजान रे
प्रेम कृपालु सुधा चाकन हित
प्रेम कृपालु सुधा
राधे राधे गाए जा
राधे राधे गाए जा
ओ राधे राधे गाए जा
राधे राधे गाए जा
ओ राधे राधे गाए जा
राधे राधे गाए जा
राधे के गुण गाए जा मन
राधे के गुण गाए जा
जीवन सफल बनाए जा
जीवन सफल बनाए जा
ओ रे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश्चि दिन गुण गन गाए जा
मोरे मोरे मन श्री राधिकार मन निश्चि दिन गुण गन गाए जा
राधा कृष्ण भगवान की
जय।
नेक्स्ट वर्स शक्नोति हैव यः सोढुं प्राक् शरीरविमोक्षणात् कामक्रोधोद्भवं वेगं स युक्तः स सुखी नरः 523 गीता ये शरीर रवि मोक्षनाथ मतलब ये शरीर को छोड़ने से पहले मोक्षनाथ अगर काम क्रोध भवम बेगम ये काम क्रोध का जो वेग होते हैं मन में इसको हम सहन कर सकते सहन कर सकते तो वो योगी सुखी है उनको ये संसार में सुख सुखी कहेंगे कह सकते सो दिस वर्स इज सेइंग वी डोंट हैव टू अटेन वेट फॉर हैप्पीनेस आफ्टर वी लीव समवन थिंग्स व्हेन आई डाई I will go to Bhagwan's abode and I will get happiness. Or I'll merge into the formless Brahma, I'll be free from all pain and suffering. No. You have to wait till then. Before leaving the body. Here Sri Krishna says, before leaving the body. Yipraakta shari ravi mokshanat. Before leaving the body. If one is able to withstand all the urges of desires, lust and anger. It's not easy. Tulsidasji says in the Ramayana, Kaam baat kapha lobha apara, krodha pitta nit chhati jara, priti karai jau teen hu bhai, upajai sanya pat dukhdai. These three are called the three doorways to hell. Narak ka dwar hai, ye teen. Kaam, krodh, lobh. Lust or desires, kaam, krodh, anger, lobh, greed. These three are told to be the most dangerous. Actually, from kaam, desires, krodh and lobh comes, greed and anger comes. Kaamat krodho bhijayate. This was done previously in chapter 2. The mother of both greed and anger is desire, lust, desire. Jab kaam aate hai man mein, isko puri hum kar sakte ya nahi kar sakte? When desire comes, a desire comes in the mind, either we can fulfill that desire, we get what we want, or we cannot fulfill it. We don't get what we want. When we fulfill that desire, you feel like eating something, you eat it. You feel like drinking something, you drink it. Kisi ko milna, waha gaake mil gaya. You want to meet somebody, you go and meet that person. You want to get a hug, you get a hug, whatever. You fulfill the desire. What happens? Na jatu kamaha kamapabho. Na jatu kamaha kamanapabhoge na shamyati. Havishya Krishna Vartmeva Bhuya Evavi Vardhate. Bhagavat Mahapuran. 9th Canto, 19th chapter, 14th verse. The Bhagavat says, trying to fulfill a desire is like pouring ghee into fire. Fuel, ghee. You do havan. Indraya Namaha Swaha, Agnaya Namaha Swaha, Vayave Namaha Swaha. When you pour that ghee in the fire, what happens? Temporarily, the fire goes down. And then it gets even bigger. When we fulfill a desire in the world, what happens? Temporarily, we are okay. I want to eat ice cream. Somebody feels like eating ice cream. Rasgulla. You 10 rasgulla. Tip. Now I'm satisfied. I don't want any more rasgulla. And tomorrow, I want more rasgulla. It only increases. This is lobe, greed. People say, why suffer yourself, man? You want the thing, eat it. You want the thing to drink, drink it. You suffer in the mind. If you die and you didn't fulfill that, you have to come back for it. People say all kind of foolishness. Somebody's dying. Oh, whole life, they control themselves from drinking alcohol. I've seen. Vegetarian. And suddenly they want to eat fish, meat, they want to drink alcohol. Give the man, give it to him. If he die thinking about that, what's going to, you know, the life won't even leave the body. If it leave, he has to come back and take birth. Maybe he'll haunt you for it. So give him the alcohol to drink, give him the meat, the fish. This is a condition. Sometimes we just forcefully force ourselves to be certain things. And we hide and do it. We hide and people think that we are something. When this yearning, this longing is in the mind. You don't have to come back because you didn't get something. You come back because you didn't cross Maya. Until we go beyond Maya, until we have crossed Maya, we will keep rotating in 8.4 million forms of life. And the actions we perform, whatever we have done while we are alive, that will determine which form of life we're going to go, where we're going to go. We don't get human birth like that. You have to have done great bhakti, attained great love for God. Someone did not attain God realization. Attained 90% love for Bhagwan, but didn't 10% remaining. Immediately can get human birth. Immediately. And we do little bhakti, 10%, 5%, you think, nah. You have to go through a lot. Then Bhagwan will shower his grace. Kabahu kakari karuna nar dehi det isha binu he tu sanehi. Very seldom, very rare, does the Supreme Lord who loves the individual soul bestow upon it birth in the human form. After millions and millions of lifetimes, we get a chance. Bhagwan apne akaran karun, out of his causeless mercy, gives us a chance to get birth in the human form. The Kathopanishad goes even further. The Kathopanishad says, Sargeshu. Ihache dashakat bodhum prakshasa visasa tata sargeshu lokeshu shariratvaya kalpate. Kathopanishad 2, 3, 4. The Kathopanishad says, hey, human beings, immediately try to attain the true goal of life, attaining God realization, attaining Krishna. Otherwise, if you don't, then you will have to rotate in the endless cycle of birth and death as ordained by divine law in the 8.4 million forms of life. Sargeshu, one sarg, the Sanskrit in Ved, different type of Sanskrit, most difficult is Ved. The word sarg here means kalp. Sarg means kalp. How much is a kalp? 4,294,080,000 years. 12 hours of Brahma is one kalp, 14 manvantar. And sargeshu, this is plural, bahubachan, plural. After many, many kalps, we get a chance. One kalp, remember one kalp, 4,294,080,000 years. And after many of those, we get a chance to get birth in the human form. We don't realize the value and the rarity of this human birth. We play the fool, we just enjoy the senses and have a good time in the world. We just want to enjoy the senses. No time for this Bhagwan and all the stuff, we say. So, fulfilling the desire gives rise to greed, which is ever increasing and insatiable. And when we cannot fulfill a desire, wo purti nahi ho sakti. Jo hum chahte hai, nahi milte hai. That which I want, I don't get. Oh, people doesn't do what I want. People don't listen to me. My children don't listen to me. My parents don't listen to me. My husband, my wife doesn't listen to me. Swamiji doesn't do what I want. we get angry. Growth. When desire is not fulfilled, anger comes. And what happens when anger comes? Krodhat bhavati sammoha, sammohat smriti vibhrama, smriti banshat buddhinasho, buddhinashat pranashyati. 263 Gita. Sri Krishna says, from anger comes delusion, from delusion loss of memory. When we lose our memory, we lose the power to discriminate and everything is destroyed. So, if one is able to control this desires, this anger. Anger is not an easy one. People in the world today, there's a lot of people do anger management. Little thing, we get angry. Throw tantrum. Mood off. Afterwards, we think about it. I was so stupid, But we get angry and everything gets destroyed. We destroy, if we are satsangi, we are doing bhakti, whatever little two tears, whatever little bhakti we were doing, little purity we made in the mind, all that is lost. The moment anger comes. So all this management and all that, try not to be angry. As long as the situation is not there, it's very easy not to be angry. When the situation comes, you can do all the anger management, all of whatever you want. Anger is going to come. Because the root is there. We have to destroy the root completely. If there's a tree that's given problem, you have this tree growing close to the house and it's affecting the foundation of the house, bringing crack in the foundation. So you're going to destroy this tree. What do? Cut the branch a little bit? Trim the branches? No. You have to attack the root of the tree. Destroy the root. The root have to take out. And the root is attachment. The root cause of all desires, all this anger, greed, jealousy, all this thing is attachment. Why do we get attached? Because we keep thinking over and over again, I'll find happiness in this person or object in the world. We get attached. That's all the problem. So if one is able to control that, and this only comes through true knowledge, through bhakti, as long as Maya is there, you cannot do it. This is very deep knowledge here. Just by reading the words alone doesn't make a sense. Doesn't make any sense. If one can control the urges of lust, of desires and anger, before he leaves the body, he will be supremely happy. But that's, you're talking about God realization? Because that person has gone beyond to control the urge of greed and anger, the lust and anger, desires, you've gone beyond Maya. So, wo bhakti mein sthir ho gaya, he's become fixed in bhakti. The yog here, the word yog being used here. काम क्रोध भवम बेगम सयुक्तम सा सुखी न रहा. So he is now in one with Bhagwan, yukta. He is joined with Bhagwan in that bliss, happiness of Bhagwan, and he experiences true happiness. So in other words, you don't have to leave. While in this world, you will attain the supreme happiness. If you can be free from the urges of greed, of lust, of anger, diseases of the mind, in other words, you're free from Maya, to put it that way. No one can be under Maya and you don't have anger. As long as Maya is there, all the diseases, all the defects of Maya. When Maya go, all will go. So in effect, one has become free from Maya. Then one experiences supreme happiness even while living in this material world. Maya is there. The whole world is Maya. It's there. But it has no effect on you anymore. Everything is going on. COVID, you name it, everything is going on. No effect on that soul. Because you no longer identify with the body and happiness in the world. And this one die and that one die and this is happening, that has happened. Doesn't affect him anymore. Because no one has died. The soul is indestructible. Nainam chindanti shastrani, I just said it. We read all these things in Gita, it cannot go and sit in the intellect because we're crying and bawling and as though somebody has died. Where's the knowledge? The one who has true knowledge does not rejoice nor lament at the birth or death of anyone. This is a true jnani. When you have that knowledge, but why are you reading Gita? That doesn't mean you have knowledge. Oh, gyan ho gaya. If the knowledge is there, then you are the wise, then you are truly wise. Then nothing in the world affects you anymore. Because you have gone, that is a truly happy person. Wo sukhi hai. He is truly happy. We'll end here tonight. Bole Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. Srimad Sadguru Sarkar ki jai. जय जय श्री राधे जय जय श्री राधे जय जय श्री राधे